Yep, second round is also best of one, so that we get things going after. And from quarterfinals, you are gonna be heading into best of threes. So far, it seems to be going rather alright. But yeah, we just in the after first round, and it's gonna be just kind of like accumulating the differences in the length of the games. So basically, obviously, the rounds are moving as fast as the slowest part, as the slowest match. So in case there's gonna be something really long, it's obviously gonna be just prolonging everything quite a bit. But well, nonetheless, here we go. We are gonna be heading into game number two of today. It's gonna be second round between Ruperrt and AotCommunity at this point. And we're gonna be getting Oasis. And that's gonna be right now Oranos from AotCommunity versus Seth from Ruperrt. Fairly interesting, actually. Ruperrt is gonna be switching from Hades into Seth. They're having blind picks, so we don't exactly see that. And they are gonna be coming for a battle. One in the match. And that means that they're gonna be basically rerolling a map. They should be keeping the gods, as far as I remember. And hi, Solo. Well, I have no choice. This is Smurf tournament. I have no idea who the players are. So I'm just gonna be picking randomly. Basically, first come, first serve. And so, I mean, like, the first game wasn't exactly like any kind of stomp or some such. It was basically won by only Restoration, otherwise it seemed like even the Atlantean was playing really well. I don't think he made any kind of significant mistakes or anything, not really. Just basically fighting under Restoration was just kind of like commitment where he thought that even through that he's probably gonna win, and he just did not. So well, let's see. Same gods, this time though a bit different map. It's gonna be slightly better. Because obviously even like on the Oasis, I mean like Set and Oranos, Atlantean is obviously pretty good there. Egyptian is not like too shabby on Oasis. Some kind of Hollow Hunt maps are quite fine for Egyptians as well. But well, there we go. There's gonna be already vision to the top. He's not gonna be apparently shifting sand in on the opponent, which is maybe a bit of a surprise. Even on Atlantean, it can be something useful. And obviously, it would be a whole lot better, for example, on Norse or a Greek. And there's a first relic for a billion LOS yet again. I think we had the same one in the first game. That's a bit surprising. Kind of funny TCs, really. You can see one in the very corner of the map for AotCommunity and the other one here. Who was actually Veto in the first game? Yeah, I'm thinking that right now AotCommunity is probably considering the Veto. I think it was Ruperrt in the first one who was actually Veto in. It would be making better sense. Because Atlantean Veto in Oasis is weird. But yeah, well, we'll see. Yeah, he's gonna be right now with Owen. So it makes sense. It definitely does make sense that he would be doing it this way. He's probably gonna be hoping for some different map. Because those TCs were really kind of weird. Not entirely all that great. And quite frankly, for both sides. Not entirely certain we would be benefiting from it more. Probably the Atlantean would be benefiting more from having TCs like these. Basically not getting any kind of map control from them. And probably also not any kind of gold. And there we go, it's gonna be Tundra. Oh, so right now I don't know if we actually can switch gods though. I have to be right now checking into the rules. Veto. To one per round, two for grand finals. My battle must be before 1 minute. Tell your god choices. Okay, so that's basically blind pick is right now fine. I actually don't think he can be switching the gods. It's not specified here, but I'm slightly thinking it's implied. Okay, one veto per round, no more. Veto resets the map, so reroll random map. But that's nothing about civilizations. I'm thinking you should be keeping same gods. I cannot exactly message them. Okay, I'm gonna be right now asking Kilty, because this is a bit strange. Nonetheless, we are having the first seconds of the game, so hopefully it's not gonna be, you're not gonna be missing anything all that significant. So hey on Veto, should they keep Gods or can they switch? I already have my guess who the player is when he's switching the Gods like that. I'm guessing you might be having as well. So let's see what Kilty tells us. But nonetheless, in the meantime, let's kind of look around, because so far Ruperrt is not complaining. So I'm guessing he's gonna be fine to play that. He probably doesn't mind all that much. On an open map like this, I don't think it's gonna be mattering too significant, really, to be frank. Especially with the skill that he has seen from Ruperrt in the previous game. Well, the gold here on the right side is kind of like similar to what we have seen in the first game. Can see that the settlement is gonna be quite far away and not exactly too much of a map control from it. It should be same gods, so yeah. So, no, well. And well, let's see how Kilty deals with that. And well, so far we're gonna be just continuing with the game. I'm thinking that Ruperrt is probably gonna be confident enough to win it anyway. So he might not be minding all that much. I have in my personal guess who actually AOT community right now is. I'm thinking it's making good sense with the name as well. I'm gonna be wondering if I'm gonna be right. I'm just gonna be letting you also think about it, who it could be, and if you're gonna be having the same idea as me. And well, thank you very much, Metal, for the host. So I'm thinking you might be potentially streaming some other games if you're gonna be having time later. But we're gonna be right now having a matchup on our hands here. I just need to be getting a bit more into the zone because this threw me off slightly. How we switched the god at the very end there. So otherwise, the front TC. Or who actually switched? Ruperrt or. Ruperrt actually switched, sorry. So, Ruperrt is the one who switched. Yeah, he really shouldn't. So, just kinda switch the names there around a bit. But the problem is still the same. So maybe they're gonna be right now saving it, we'll see. Because they're right now finally figuring out. it almost seems like Alt-F4-ing, quite frankly. So have they already gone out? Well, AOT community definitely left. So I'm thinking at this point that he either Alt F4'd or he just pulled the cord, or I don't know. So we can just basically go out at this point. Like, post game's not gonna be telling us anything. Just kind of funny that it ended at the same score. So we're gonna be having Re. Which I think there goes the idea of potentially having two games streamed for the second round. Okay, I'm gonna be right now asking Kilty if they should be keeping the last map, because it kinda makes sense to me that they should be keeping the map. Even though it's still random, so it's not like he was picking the god because of the map. So probably doesn't matter too much what they're gonna be playing. Now, funny part is that he basically changed only after second veto. After first veto, he kept the set, but he changed after the second veto. So, yeah. It's all kind of funny. Okay, and Kilty says that she wants another random, okay? And everybody is having just one veto in the match, just in case somebody missed it. Only finals you're gonna be having two. And useless Orihim Duhovki, what it means. That's basically Czech, oldest Czech coin found on our in our land, let's say. It's from the 1st century BC, and it's a Celtic stater. And in Czech it's called duhovky. Even in English it's called rainbow cups. And it was called that way because they were usually found on fields after rains. And so they kind of used, or rather they were kind of like colorful and glinting and everything like that. And there was also a bit of like a myth around it that they were basically just at the bottom of a rainbow. So there you go. Rainbow cups in English. And in Czech, it's duhovky. So I'm using the duhovky in Czech because in in English, the name is a bit weird to me, I guess, in a way. So I'm kind of rather using the Czech one for the channel points. Okay, Hagrid, so you potentially could be having some kind of stream as well. Because there are plenty of games, plenty of rounds, obviously, so that we can be streaming as many games as possible. And AotCommunity right now complaining that he's playing an unfair map. Yeah, that's kind of what I was talking about the map. But at the same time, yet again, he wasn't playing. He wasn't playing, or rather choosing the god because of the map, obviously. So I do understand both sides, but we'll see. Right now, Oranos versus Set. Obviously, the Egyptian is going to be having quite a nice map for him. As Midgard is an eggy map. Whereas, that's just... Nah, not really. At the same time... I just understand both points of view. I don't think that either of those would be stupid. But at the same time, either of them doesn't have like a precedence. 15% building hit points for the Nose of the Sphinx is quite nice. Well, that's just gonna be a bit of a challenge, I guess, for AotCommunity. He can be maybe just trying to rush the opponent. Because obviously, I'm thinking that Ruperrt is gonna be going for a bit of a boom himself. And it's just also gonna depend where he's having all the golds. For example, this gold mine is a bit further away from the TC. It's not like insurmountably far away, but it is still good enough. It's still kind of good enough here, and I'm thinking this is going to be quite natural for Ruperrt to be trying to go for. Quite soon into the game. So this is something that AotCommunity should be trying to abuse by some kind of fast advance. Though at the same time, sets usually advance quite quickly themselves. So it's not really that much of a, like... 100% possibility that he's gonna be able to be so quick, but nonetheless, you can see he's having so far quite nice fishies in the corner. There are gonna be already a few more of them for Ruperrt all the way to the left, but he seems to be a bit more aiming to the top side. He's even trying to protect the dock with all the houses. And Pegasus Rush, exactly. Mega X Blast, that's a very good player, isn't he? That's a very good player. But nonetheless, just basically to finish what I was saying, there's gonna be a Wolfie that is coming from the bottom side, so potentially a bit of a problem, which might be right now forcing Ruperrt into basically the bottom side rather than the top. You can see there are gonna be a few fishing spots here all around. There should be probably a triple somewhere about like there, I'm guessing about like here. It's gonna be possible. As for the opponent, he's gonna be having to fish for the fishies as well, and for him it doesn't matter exactly where he's gonna be coming, because obviously he's basically built himself right into the middle of the water, so not really any kind of great boon to be gained for him, wherever he's gonna be coming. In the meantime, the front TCs are kind of funny. I'm looking at especially this one, that would be fairly interesting to AotCommunity, or rather Ruperrt, and AotCommunity should be paying attention to it, because I'm expecting that maybe Ruperrt could be making some kind of run for it. And if he did, and it was successful, then he would be getting maybe even this gold mine for himself. So some kind of interesting options are right now cropping up, but still nothing really all that sure. And I'm thinking that the first natural TC is gonna be certainly this one. He's having the one for the building hit points. That's gonna be certainly helpful for the Egyptian in the defense. And the temple right now being built to basically just protect the gold mine. It's gonna be probably good enough for the early game. And I'm really only curious if AotCommunity or Ruperrt, basically both of them, are gonna be trying to fight. But you can see that Ruperrt is gonna be embracing the set all across the board here. Yeah, it's gonna be quite a nice dog here on the left side. Probably another dog about like this position would be nice. I'm expecting as the front one to the top is gonna be built by the fishing boat because of the wolfie nearby, as he doesn't want to be risking the villager all that much. Wouldn't be surprised too much if there was another fish about like here. There's still a bit of ground, or rather water, to be covered in there. So far we don't see where's the next gold mine. You only see this one for AotCommunity at the bottom. Still could be something funny about like there, but you don't see, we don't know. And the first advance is gonna be apparently coming quite quickly, or rather quickly, quicker and faster for AOT community, which is maybe a bit surprising, because you could be expecting that Ruperrt might be advancing faster, but apparently he is already going for quite a heavy water build, and that could be actually a bit of an advantage for him. And I'm talking about AOT community, because if he's going this late for quite a heavy boom into the fishing boats, therefore he's probably gonna be fighting for the water. Look at that nasty spam. My heart bleeds just basically watching this. And this is why Midgard is such a heavy eggy map. Because only Egyptians can be doing this kind of nonsense and making the water work for them even over time, as opposed to the other civilizations. But I'm really liking the aggressive approach by AOT community, and I'm thinking that's what he needs to be doing. Not only blocking this TC, so that potentially it isn't taking good scouting on the other one, he needs to be making sure that this town center is not going anywhere, and that he's gonna be controlling the gold mines all across the map, especially this combination needs to be fully controlled if he does want to be standing any kind of chance in the game. And it's gonna be already Valor coming forward on the starting army. He didn't get the villager, obviously, but oh, he did. Yeah, he did. You always want to be getting the first heroic villager as well. And obviously, right now, with late advance, that's gonna be Anubis. Anubis coming forward for the early defense. Not even coming for the shifting sense as the set. That's actually fairly interesting. And how many monuments do we have? So far, one. So I was just kind of looking if maybe there's gonna be some kind of fun shenanigans going on with the Anubites. So far, you don't exactly think so. But well, at least they're gonna be snakies, potentially for the water, but I don't think it's really all that needed and all that necessary. As AOT community is so far basically not even fighting for the water, literally only one dog, and I don't think that's such a bad choice. I mean, like, he can, as an Atlantean, really supply such a heavy pressure that his main goal in the game is going to be preventing the gold, the secondary gold for the opponent, rather for him. And therefore, if he can do that, then the game would be just basically won right there. But it's gonna be a bit of a tall task and tall order, obviously. Just basically what he needs to be doing right now is raiding around and trying to kill as many whales as possible and trying to slow down the enemy, because obviously on the water he probably doesn't want to be fighting too badly. Just wants to be just faking the battle, maybe forcing Ruperrt to invest in a bit more resources than he would be happy with and comfortable with doing. And if he's gonna be succeeding with those and with that, then he's gonna be fine. So I do see the chance, but at the same time, Ruperrt does have, of course, the huge boost of the water economy. He can be just making a few boats and pretty much do the same what AOT community did a bit before. And therefore, if he's gonna be succeeding with taking the secondary TC here, then the game should be and could be quite nicely going for him. And obviously, on top of it, he could be also having just the ancestors in the heroic age, so that's gonna be obviously quite a good assistance as well. Problem is that the Valored heroes for the opponent, if he's gonna be keeping them alive, are probably gonna be shredding the ancestors fairly simply and promptly. Okay, so the animals are right now dying. Apparently even the cow is gonna be stolen as the PC is gonna be dead. And he should be careful not to lose the heroes too badly. For exactly what I said, and that is just making sure that he is having something against the ancestors. But obviously right now going into the villages, into the middle, interesting idea, but he's also heavily shot at. And I would be liking if, for example, TC's, he is purposefully selecting the heroes there, and that's very well played, because he needs to be exactly thinking himself about the ancestors that are probably gonna be securing him the gold mine a bit later, with at least how the game is going, or securing, like, the only chance to secure him the gold mine. That's a bit better said there. Okay, so right now he's gonna be falling back. He's having still 2 and 2, but the heroes are not entirely all that. Actually, they are reasonably high health so far, as on the water you can see that AOT community is continuing with the battle and trying to force the opponent into a bit of an awkward situation, as he's obviously controlling the map and therefore he's gonna be hunting for the rest of the game, allowing him to be having quite a good amount of resources trickling in, as obviously is the fastest source of food. But thing is, at least for the time being, Blue doesn't exactly need to be switching, as he's right now advancing through Neftis. Doesn't need to be switching all that much into the farming yet. So therefore the gold is gonna be still enough for him for the time being. But he's right now having 500 left. He's gonna be having 700. So yep, this is gonna be right now looking at the Migdol somewhere. Probably right now defensive. And that would be pretty bad for him if it actually that had to happen. It's the AOT community, not advancing. Ruperrt though. I'm right now slightly wondering if he could be trying fast mythic. Because he's gonna be having plenty of food still. The gold is obviously a bit tricky, but he still does have exactly 200 here. He can be building a market, selling a bit of wood, maybe a bit of food. So this is gonna be fairly interesting to see what kind of decision he's gonna be taking. If he's gonna be just coming straight for the middle somewhere. So far it's gonna be secondary barracks. With the Pharaoh coming forward, right now repelling the army. And of course right now with the free Leviathan, that's gonna be quite a huge boon and boost. And making sure that he's gonna be controlling the waters and it's not gonna be really destroyed. At the same time, there's gonna be a second TC already coming up from AOT community. Let's check some eco upgrades. Nothing for the Atlantean. He's going really hardcore for the opponent's handaxe and pickaxe. So right now this is gonna be the important part of the game. And does he have enough units? So far, not so much. You can see the auto queues are only on 1 and 1. So he doesn't want to be overdoing it, so therefore probably slightly thinking about also heroic age himself. Just needs to be really keeping the Murmill safe as long as possible. Because right now, even if the villagers move, he's moving for this gold, or rather for this TC. Really? Well, if so, then kind of good luck. Yeah, that was very weird movement by Ruperrt, quite frankly. Or is he using them as army? Not entirely positive. It was looking halfway here that he was actually moving for the settlement. I'm a bit concerned by the fact that actually Red is not scouting this gold at all. I mean, like we see it, but he could be easily scouting with one Promethean. So he basically giving a bit of a chance to Ruperrt in case he managed to notice that and use it for himself. Right now that's gonna be the market. And AOT community. Okay, Ruperrt not going for the mythical age. That's definitely right now, sure. And with the heroes though being dead, he doesn't have valor anymore. Ancestors are gonna be a problem. Ancestors are gonna be a problem, but maybe not even, because you can see he's already on the goal to the top. And even though AOT community sees exactly that, he's gonna be right now moving around. That's a bit of a help, actually, this forest, because it's making the movement for AOT community a bit harder. And Ruperrt's gonna be having a bit easier defense. That's also partly why he was placing the market here, to block the path slightly, and because he just had the units in there. That's the same spot. But right now getting the TC is actually quite important, but without the gold, it doesn't matter that significantly much, because you can see right now the gold is off. It's probably gonna be forced to sell a bit of wood, which he quite easily could be doing. But the number of units for right now community is slightly worrying me. He's getting the plow, because right now this is gonna be all about the gold mine. There are already barracks up. Army is there, but he's gonna be actually strong enough, because right now these are already medium axemen, and right now of course he's gonna be getting tons of barracks. He just needs to be getting the pharaoh for the empowerment, so that he's gonna be having as much income as possible. Right now villagers moving forward for this TC, oh yeah, and he's gonna be apparently caught here. Okay, so that's gonna be a bit of a problem for him. It was an interesting idea, because this is gonna be giving him so many gold mines, even potentially by proxy, the gold mines on the left side. But yeah, well, this is not gonna be finishing. You can see ancestors to protect, and without any kind of heroes here whatsoever. And you can see he doesn't have all that many resources for that. The food is missing absolutely big time. Well, not entirely positive, he's gonna be able to stop this fully, but he could be getting some kind of secondary army, and the game is suddenly completely falling apart, quite frankly, for AOT community. Was just basically really well played by Ruperrt, I have to say. And at the same time, I'm thinking that actually community could have played it slightly better as far as the control of the map. And just basically what we were talking about all the time, keeping the heroes in reserve. Because as soon as he doesn't have heroes, he just cannot fight the ancestors. If he had the heroes here, basically even 4 Murmills, he'll be able to really slaughter the ancestors quite fine. But well, at this point, with all the units and even the army from Ruperrt being in place, even though there is gonna be basic raiding at the same time, so that's not a bad idea, it's still not gonna be good enough, apparently, as he just doesn't have enough units to fight all the time. And Ruperrt is actually going real hardcore, even for the 3rd TC available. So he's gonna be right now aiming for a 4th one, and damn. Ruperrt is right now gonna be all over the place, even though he's gonna be losing the battle on the left side without the ancestors. In the long run, it's still not gonna be such a bad loss, because this TC is gonna be apparently finished. At least it seems that way to me. And in the middle, it seems to me that he's gonna be finishing as well. Top side is completely safe, right next to the gold mine. I don't think there's any kind of problem with that at all. Is he actually hugging this too close? I don't think he is. But well, nonetheless, efficiency is not his problem at this more at this point. Those gold mines from AOT community in there. And building right basically TC in the middle of the enemy forward base. Yeah, well, not entirely all that awesome. Not entirely all that awesome here for him. But this is definitely right now coming into Ruperrt's hands because he's having all 4 TCs, he's suddenly getting so many gold mines all across the map. And therefore, as on the water, he has also managed to basically completely wipe out AOT community, because he just, even especially against the Leviathan, he couldn't fight all that much. It's gonna be quite hard for him to be really coming back. And you can see the difference in the score, 800 points, and it's gonna be becoming way worse as time goes. He does have plenty of gold so far, AOT community, but the heroic cage is still evading him. Whereas for the opponent, he's gonna be happy in the heroic and just having the boost of all the extra population limit that he can be hoping for. And of course, he's gonna be waiting for the siege works coming forward a bit later. He's gonna be probably safe. He's gonna be apparently safe as well with a bit of extra walling right now being available here. Apparently hotkeyed wall, it seems. Who knows? It's slightly strange in there, but nonetheless, we are gonna be right now wall, or rather, hotkeyed gate, rather, not wall in there. Still, AOT community is not willing to give up, which is definitely quite a correct like approach to the game, because we are playing best of one in the second round, and therefore, well, if he's gonna be using these out of the tournament, therefore it makes all kinds of sense to be continuing fighting and potentially trying to disrupt Ruperrt, because still taking 4 TCs at pretty much once within like a few minutes is always a bit risky play, especially this early into the game. But the thing is that he's having such a fishing economy right now with Pursane already there. So could be also going for Saltam for a Sundam soon, and therefore he should be having still enough to basically continue villager production until he's gonna be pulled, which he already potentially could be. And therefore, shouldn't be having in the end as much of a problem as maybe you could be thinking at one time. But Hyperion is on the way, 45 PC as well, with Ruperrt not heading into the Mythical Age yet. He doesn't have even the population limit right now covered. But the AOT community is probably gonna be jumping, or rather jumping right after. It seems to me. He's so far having quite a nice rating on the gold mine. Unfortunately, the secondary gold mine is also being taken as well. You can see Monument Soldiers already coming up. As a few more Slingers are right now coming for a bit of raiding themselves. And that is a very good gold mine for AOT community. Remember what you were talking about a bit earlier? That was basically, if there's gonna be a good gold mine for AOT community, you could be having quite a solid map. That's gonna be a vision into the middle of the base. With even Ruperrt right now building the dock at the back of the enemy base so that he can be gathering fishies a bit more efficiently in there. But that's only a theoretical, not really that much of an important part, as there's gonna be a bit of a chaos all the way to the top, which didn't take all that much of an army, basically just a 3 slingers it seems like. But yeah, well, against the Atlanteans, the siege towers, together with the slingers, are gonna be quite a bit of a problem, as satyrs are right now coming forward yet again. And are they gonna be strong enough this time? Well, they are a bit more expensive. But let's see how they're gonna be dealing with, or rather, how he's gonna be dealing with them this time around. But so far it seems to me, as there's also gonna be a bit of raiding with the little Prometheans from the very start of the game, that Ruperrt will be slightly slowed down here, but definitely not stopped, because this gold is way too excellent with Shaft Mine for him. But with the Hecate, still something could happen, and the Atlantean does have a few options how to come back, maybe even going for the Titan, though he doesn't have the favor for that yet. He would have to definitely spare his building of the Satyrs, which doesn't seem to be the case, and therefore he's hoping that that's gonna be good enough. But looking at all of those siege towers, yeah, that's usually the bane of the Atlantean, and it seems to be exactly this at this point in the game. So Hecate is right now 40% in. So maybe there's gonna be a bit of a chance that the siege towers are gonna be actually in the TC even faster than that. That is certainly quite a solid possibility. So you're gonna be right now looking at even switching to a bit of a Kontara, which is not a bad idea, considering all the especially slingers. And even against the medium Axemen, it doesn't have to be too bad, because they don't have high attack, they don't have bonus against horses, but still, 40% melee armor is really kinda badass for them. And therefore, the horses are not gonna be entirely all that extremely strong against them. As you can see, they attack at 11, so basically they're gonna be dealing like, I don't know, 6 damage, something along those lines. So it's not too high. But at the same time, it's also not too bad. So, kind of okay unit against both of these. But looking right now how he's gonna be losing the whole base. Hecate is gonna be in the end actually finishing just at the nick of time. But can he use it somehow effectively and do some kind of good effect? I'm not entirely really positive. But he's doing what he can, as the place has been at least finished. And therefore, he's gonna be able to survive a bit longer. So the game is still not really finished yet, but you would have to be right now able to basically block the gold mines, and this is, I'm thinking, reasonably alright. I'm thinking this is actually in mind of blocking both the gold mines and also the TC. So I don't think it's actually some kind of stupid idea, it's actually pretty solid. So let's see how he's gonna be dealing with that, the opponent. So right now, military barracks through top with a few Kontari, and this though by Ruperrt. Yeah, well, unfortunately, AotCommunity, community, not sure if he noticed, but if he did not, then this is gonna be a nasty surprise for him, obviously. So far, the game seems to be slightly turning, but well, as soon as the Speedmen right now are making up an appearance, but making an appearance in the battle, it's not looking great for the red player yet again. So Copper Shields fortify TC right now for AotCommunity community for a bit more population limit, obviously quite needed. Otherwise, Ruperrt not advancing into the Mythical Age at all. Can see he basically investing everything into a heroic cage, but at the same time it means that he doesn't have all that many ups, and getting only copper shields is not entirely gonna be helping him against the combination of units that he's so far facing. But considering the fact that he's gonna be also facing the Satyr still, and he's gonna be also facing a few more Kontari pretty quickly, doesn't seem all that impossible. And so far we are not entirely out of the possibility of a massive comeback here for AotCommunity community. Let's see. So I would be exactly liking him actually to show up on the water again. Problem is he doesn't have all that much of a pop for that. But I'm thinking like 1-2 siege boats and just maybe even arrow boats to just abuse Ruperrt a bit to waste his population limit so that he has to react with his own boats and maybe overreact and basically hope that it's gonna be working that way for him. Could be some kind of idea. But nonetheless, right now, the spawns are trying to also what they can to do what they can against the siege towers. The Tataran gate is gone. There are gonna be still a few spawns on the left side to protect the gold mine, potentially. But not really good enough. As right now, it's gonna be easy for the TC to get rid of it. It still did slow down Ruperrt quite significantly. As from the back, there was a bit of raiding by the Chariot Arches because of the taken gold mine on the right side. And of course, right now, the spam of the units from here is gonna be quite deadly. And there's gonna be a chaos all the way through top. Unfortunately, no mythical units, obviously. But he's gonna be taking at least a few Chariot Arches. I think about he has taken about like two in a slinger. But definitely not strong enough anymore. As on the balance patch 4-0, he has only two charges. They're right now all but depleted. And it's gonna be all about right now getting some more ups for AotCommunity community above Ruperrt before there's gonna be the Mythical Age. So finally Saltamphora, about like 10 minutes too late, but better late than never. It's some copper weapons coming forward from Ruperrt as well. At least right now having the whole copper line for him already. Already bronze shields and copper mail for the Atlantean, it's not too bad. I wonder if it would be worthwhile for him to go for Titan. I'm slightly worried that maybe not even. That's gonna be a very nasty raid in here. Can see already two citizens dead. It's gonna be third one, fourth one, and I definitely seen about at least the fifth one. Yep. So, okay, so this is right now quite a GG material. Five citizens dead at this stage of the game. If this didn't happen, I think that AotCommunity community, he can see how he was crawling back into the game. Even on the score difference, only 600 points, but this is just gonna be setting him back so badly. So badly. Yeah, I'm not entirely certain he's gonna be able to competently come back from that. At the same time, in the middle, he's doing what he can with what he has been given, and he's obviously at only 2 TC, so the population limit is not too bad. But for the opponent, be that all the 180 population limit, he's just basically allowing, or rather allowed, to be having so many units on all kinds of venues all across the map that even though he's being attacked, for example, at the back TC, he's also being attacked here. Funnily enough, the AotCommunity community is trying to get whatever gold that he can find all across the map. It seems to be quite a bit harder for the red player than he would be comfortable with, for obvious reasons. But at the same time, it's also a whole lot harder for Ruperrt, I'm thinking, than he would be wanting and liking. So that's a bit curious. I'm just gonna be checking on the economical side. 105, that's fine. He's not overdoing ECOP, so he's having plenty of units himself. Heavy chariots with already bronze metal, for example, in there. Can see medium fanatics and same armor as we have seen a bit before. So this AotCommunity community having a bit of a problem with the echo for obvious reasons. We know exactly why. And as they are moving back, So is moving back Ruperrt. And are we gonna be having a repeat? Oh, he missed that. Oh, that's a bit of a disappointment. But bit of a luck for AOT community. They actually didn't see all those gold miners that are available. As well, obviously right now this is gonna be just a continued trading by kind of like both sides. You can see that AOT community is trying to get rid of the Migdol, but it's definitely not succeeding. So right now he's gonna be losing plenty of citizens to just superior power. And that Ruperrt is having on the battlefield just because of having more units, because of the higher population limit cap that he is having. And AOT community, he still does have good resources, but he probably should be getting a bit more military buildings because he seems to be struggling with the production capability. He's having about like 4 counter barracks. Oh, the military barracks. Doesn't have auto queue in all of them. So right now seems to be switching into different villages. Well, the different villages. Into different types of units in there. Into a few more Murmilos. As well, this gold is still available here with 2,000. That's not a bad number. That's really good still. And could be really going a long way towards the success here. Problem is that right now the upgrades are finally coming for Ruperrt. You can see all of the heavy slingers. He's having still the same here, but it's probably gonna be changing soon. You can see bronze shields, even Plow and Carpenter. So right now Ruperrt thinking that even the fishing is not going to be strong enough for him. And like having high enough production for his boats, for his economy. As the opponent is right now, it's still the same that we have seen before as well. Just trying to keep in those units busy. Whereas he's trying to still desperately get down with the Migdol. As he is looking at least the 700 gold to be continued with that. But basically the missing of the villages here by Ruperrt, that's one of the things that is basically still keeping this game alive. Because I'm thinking if he was there and basically destroyed the villages as they were in, it probably he would be able to do so. Then it might have been already tilting AOT community, but he's really fighting like a lion at this point. And trying to give it everything that he can. But the longer the game goes, as we said a bit before, the more upgrades are slowly coming in, and the more of an advantage is Ruperrt getting. But definitely quite a nice effort by AOT community. Irrigation boiling oil. And Ruperrt still doggedly fighting in the heroic age, even at 26 minutes. And it seems to be kind of working for him, so why not? But at the same time, it's also one of the reasons and one of the things that is giving AOT community the chance here. Because he simply doesn't have the spike, for example, with the catapults. Because catapults are making tons of difference. They would be just completely leveling all the military buildings for the opponent. And it would be very hard for AOT community to get anywhere nearby. Now well, I'm gonna be right now falling back a bit here on the battle, but he's already gonna be right now calling it a GG, as it was a bit of a fight against the windmills. But definitely great effort, because it wasn't looking all that impossible for quite a long time before Ruperrt finally started getting the upgrades. As long as he was unupgraded, it was looking really like AOT community could be even pulling it off with the Atlantean, but unfortunately, in the end, basically the claiming of all the TCs in the middle of the map by Ruperrt was way too strong and way too bold. And this can yet again be basically timed to the ancestors and to the claim for the gold. Especially the ancestors, I'm thinking more than the claim for the gold. Because the ancestors allowed him to be taking the second and fourth, or like the third and fourth TC. So you just need to keep in and having more heroes for that. Fortunately, that wasn't exactly what went on in this game. What could have happened? And Ruperrt is gonna be advancing through quarterfinals. And AOT community even threw quite a gritty performance and being so close by to making a nice comeback, is gonna be eliminated. Well, we'll see who it actually was, if he's gonna be revealing himself or not later. And let's check into the postgame and then head in into potentially the third round. So here we are, Ruperrt with the highest score, obviously. But we have basically noticed a time where the difference was only like 600, 500 points between the players. That was exactly when it was looking really close. And you can see the economy is not that significantly different. I mean, like, considering that Ruperrt was at 4 TCs and having huge water for like the majority of the game, the difference is really not that high. And that's also the reason why AOT community was able to keep it together for such a long time there. But of course, since he had to be fighting a long time, and he just didn't have enough water to be allowing him some standard 30 minutes heroic age for the Atlantean, he just really couldn't do anything too much with that. It was a pretty good trade-in. It was also, I think, in when they were fighting for the TCs or not. No, TCs were around like the ancestors here. So this was a bit of a raid-in later. You can see it was quite a fall here. Now, well, of course, these were the villages that were looking like they were coming for the front TC right next to his base the first time. And they were getting killed in the process by AOT community's army here. Not well, quite a spike here by Ruperrt. Of course, but after ancestors, and that's kinda... Without the heroes here, the ancestors are really problematic. But, yeah, that was exactly what Ruperrt was obviously playing at. Trying to pick off the heroes, he was purposefully doing it. And it worked out. And AOT community just didn't have the echo to be producing so many heroes at... At that time in the game, which obviously is not much of a wonder. He also didn't have too many military or other economical upgrades, that's also true. But on the water, yeah, well, build order is slightly different, but GG nonetheless, quite a nice game.